Welcome to your second video on me verbs. This one will cover subjunctives and optatives of the present and the aorist, and it goes with sections 100 and 102 of Hansen and Quinn, the parts that cover the subjunctive and the optative. You'll find those parts on pages 343 and 347 and 372 and 375 of Hansen and Quinn. So you've already been introduced to me verbs and how, unlike luo and the other thematic verbs, didomi, tithemi, and histemi, our example verbs so far, have differences mostly in the first principal part and the third principal part, although our troublemaker, histemi, also has an interesting fourth principal part. For everything from the first principal part, we've already covered the indicative of the present and imperfect, and now we're going to cover the subjunctive and the optative of the present. For the things from the third principal part, this video will cover the subjunctive and the optative of the aorist. Now, the present subjunctive active for athematic verbs comes from first principal part, and then we'll need some endings. And those are, in fact, the endings that you already know, o, ace, a, omen, ata, oc. But we're in me verbs now, so we have to think about long grade versus short grade stems. And if you look at the qualifications to get a long grade stem, present subjunctive active immediately fails because it's not indicative. So all of the stems that we're going to use, singular and plural, for the present subjunctive active will be short grade stems. And the way the subjunctive works with these me verbs is that each of the verbs acts as a contract verb of its respective kind. So ditto me will act like an omicron contract verb. Tithemi will act like an epsilon contract verb. Histemi will act like an alpha contract verb. And that means when we put in the recessive accent, we're going to follow contract verb rules, and the accents will look like this. And so we get dido, didos, dido, didomen, didota, didosi, titho, tithes, tithe, tithomen, titheta, tithosi, and histo, histes, histe, histomen, histeta, histosi. So these should look like very familiar endings, and I hope that they won't trouble you. And the only real difference in how they look is where the accent falls. Now, if we move on to the aorist subjunctive active, we're going to need the third principal part, but of course we will have it unaugmented, so we'll take off the augment. Now, here's where it's a lot of fun, because all we have to do to learn the forms for the aorist subjunctive active of me verb is to take the reduplication of the first principal part off of the stems, use our short grade stem, because this is not indicative, and take off that first principal part reduplication. And so if I erase all of these little forms here, what we get, following the same rules, that is to say, the endings that you know for the subjunctive active, combining with the short stem of the me verb and following contract verb rules, we'll get do, dos, do, domen, dota, dosi, tho, thes, the, thomen, theta, thosi, sto, stes, stay, stomen, steta, stosi. So in my excitement to show you that magic easy difference between the present and the aorist subjunctive, I forgot to mention one thing about how didomi behaves with the subjunctive endings. When you learned omicron contract verbs, omicron combines with eta and an iota subscript to become omicron and an iota, an oi. But here, as you can see in the second person and third person singular, eta iota subscript contracted with an omicron becomes omega with an iota subscript. So that's the only difference in the rules. But what's nice about it is you can see very clearly how subjunctive those endings are. Now, the present subjunctive middle passive for athematic verbs, of course, comes from first principle part. And again, it's the endings that you already know. Again, it's not indicative, and so we'll use the short grade stems, and here they are. And once again, the rule here is to combine those middle passive subjunctive endings that we already know with the short grade stems and treat them as contract verbs. Once again, in the second person singular of ditto me, omicron contracts with eta and an iota subscript and becomes omega and an iota subscript, which isn't what your contraction chart shows you from omicron contract verbs. So let's go on to see what happens with tithemi, and then histemi as an alpha contract. And when we put the recessive accent in by contract verb rules, this is what we're going to see. Didomai, dido, didotai, didometha, didostha, didontai. Tithomai, tithe, tithetai, tithometha, tithestha, tithontai. Histomai, histe, histetai, histometha, histestha, histontai. Now, if we switch to the aorist, it's going to be the third principal part and endings, but not with a augment. And of course, it won't be passive either because we only get the middle from the third principal part. And once again, we get to do this little magic with taking off that beginning reduplication. And we get, just that easy, the aorist subjunctive middle of ditto me and tithe me. Now, I'm going to get rid of all of the present subjunctive middle passive of histemi because, as you already know, the third principal part that we get the middle from for histemi is the transitive one, este sa, and it behaves exactly as sigma alpha aorists have always behaved. The other third principal part, estain, is for the intransitive meaning and doesn't have a middle. So there is no aorist subjunctive middle for tithemi. But now we have domai, do, dotai, dometha, dostha, dontai, thomai, the, thetai, thometha, thestha, thontai for the aorist subjunctive middle of didomi and tithemi. That's it for the subjunctive. It's time to move on to the present optative active of athematic verbs, of me verbs. Again, it's present, so first principal part and endings. And those endings are iain, ies, ie, iamen, ieta, iesan. Now, it's optative. And as we've often seen, there are alternate endings. And so in the plural, we could also have imen, ite, ien. And I'll show you how all of this works. Now we need to figure out which grade stem we're going to use. And right away we know we're going to use none of the long grade stems because it's not indicative, it's optative. So we're going to do the ones for all the other forms, which, as you know now, are the short grade stems. Here, with the optative, these endings that start with an iota, so characteristic of the optative, simply get added right on the end of the short grade stems. And as you can see, especially after we add the recessive accent, they form very nice diphthongs. So didoyen, didoyes, didoye, didoyemen, didoyeta, didoyesan. The same thing is going to happen when we go to tithemi. Except in combination with tithemi's epsilon, it becomes a different diphthong. Tithein, titheyes, titheye, titheyemen, titheyeta, titheyesan. And then with histemi, in combination with the alpha of the short-graded stem of histemi, we get histiein, histieis, histiae, histiemen, histieta, histieson. So here, the endings don't have a thematic vowel for the different tenses. They simply have the markers for optativeness, and that's those iotas, and for the persons. And that's how, when we add them to these athematic verb stems, we get these forms. Now, we still have to deal with those alternate endings for the plural. So let's get rid of the endings we already did and show you that we'll simply slap these other alternate endings on to those stems. And again, it forms the nice diphthongs. The rule here, though, is that in the optative of athematic verbs, the accent, even though it's recessive, still never recedes back farther than the iota. And if you follow that rule plus the other rules for accent, you'll get these accents, because that means it has to stay on the second to last syllable. The last syllable of didoimen, didoita, and didoian are all short, and so the circumflex rule comes into play, and that's why all of those little red accents are circumflexes. Let's see what happens with tithemi when we put on the alternate endings. This time again, it forms the diphthong with epsilon, and when we add the accents by that same rule, can't go back farther than the iota, we get tithemen, titheta, titheon. And one more time with histemi, in combination with the alpha, and following those rules for accent, can't go back farther than the iota, we get histaimen, histaita, histaion. If we move on to the aorist, optative active, we're going to need the third principal part. And we're not indicative, so we don't need an augment. And now we do that magic thing, and we get rid of those reduplicated first principal part, beginning of the word, letters, and we do that to all of the forms too. And there we have, by magic, doyen, doyes, doye, doymen, doita, doyen, theyen, theyes, theye, theymen, theta, theyen, styen, styes, stye, stymen, styta, styen. I think you'll probably have no problem recognizing the optatives of me verbs because of that characteristic iota. It's just so easy to see that these are optative. And you'll know when they're so short like this, without the reduplicated stem of the present, that they are the aorist ones. Of course, in the plural for all of these, you could also use the iemen, ieta, iesan endings, but I think you understand how that works now. And we're going to go on to the present, optative, middle passive for me verbs, for athematic verbs. Principal part one, plus the endings. And as you can see, we're going to follow the same logic here, except instead of active person markers, we're going to have the secondary middle passive person markers. Imain, ia, ita, imetha, istha, nta. So again, they've got the iota of the optative and the person markers that you know so well. The only anomaly is in the second person singular, where the sigma has dropped out. So once again, we're not indicative, so we're going to go with the, and now we're not active either, so we're going to go with the short grade stem that we use for all other forms. And again, we get to slap those endings onto the short stem, and the iota will form these beautiful diphthongs. The rule is it doesn't go back farther than the iota, and so that's why we have the circumflexes here, and we get didoimen, didoia, didoita, didoimetha, didoistha, didointa. Let's see it happen with tithemi, and we'll put in the accents. Tithemen, excuse me, tithemen, titheia, titheta, tithemetha, tithestha, tithenta. Now, it's the optative, and it's going to cause us a little bit of trouble. And it's the me verbs, and they're going to cause us a little bit of trouble because they're so common. And I have to tell you now that there are alternate forms for three of the persons and numbers of tithemi. Here we have, you can see there, little under the third person singular, tithoita. I think you'll recognize here the oita ending that you already know for the present optative middle passive. And it does here what you saw happening with the subjunctives a few slides ago. Tithemi, the short grade stem, acts as an epsilon contract stem that contracts with oita, the optative ending that you already know. And that's what happens in all of the plural for these alternate endings that you will see sometimes. So again, I think it won't be any problem for you to recognize those as optative middle passive endings, but you just have to remember that you might see both sets when you encounter tithemi. But when we get to histemi, it goes back to the simple one set of endings that forms the nice diphthong with an alpha, and we get histimane, histia, histita, histimetha, hististha, histinta. So if we move on to the aorist, an aorist middle, because of course the third principal part gives us no aorist passive, and we have to take off the augment, once again, we get to do this thing where we take off the stem of the reduplicated beginning of the present stem, and those forms that you get when you do that are the aorist optative middle forms for didomi and tithemi. Again, we're getting rid of the histemi present optative middle because the aorist optative doesn't have a special middle for histemi. If you need the middle of the transitive of histemi, you're going to do the endings that you already know with estesa. And of course, there is no middle for estane, the intransitive aorist of histemi. And there you have it. That's the subjunctive and the optative of me verbs. Good luck with your drills and enjoy your new variety of verbs.